99% of all failures come from people that have a habit of making excuses. George Washington Carver said that. Do you know how many of us literally make excuses for the things that we do? Do you know how many of us don't take accountability for the things that we do? We have such a hard time picking up the things that are ours and saying, this belongs to us. We want to point the blame at everybody else. This happens so much in my household that it doesn't even make any sense. Nobody in my household is ever accountable for anything unless I literally sit down and grill them. Why does it take all that? Why do you need to be told that you did something when you know good and well that it belongs to you? Being accountable is about having integrity. And integrity is doing the right thing when nobody's looking. And to be honest with you, somebody's always looking. God is looking, seriously. And not to be funny, especially the people that take the boogers out their nose and flick them on the wall. God's watching you, and other people see that and it's gross, so stop doing that, like literally. But being accountable is about setting the tone for taking all the things that you need in account and bringing them in and saying, okay, this is me, this belongs to me, that belongs to me, that belongs to me, that belongs to me, and then going from there, taking your things and being accountable. Accountability is the difference between success and failure. Let me tell you why. When you take accountability, you have more successes because you literally acknowledge your failures. When you don't take accountability, your failures literally manifest and they keep growing. And they grow and they grow and they grow. It's because nobody is going to say that they need to fix something if they don't take accountability that it doesn't need to be fixed. So be honest with yourself. Be real with yourself. Have humility. Have the courage to say, yo, I'm accountable for these things. These are my things and they belong to me. When you're being accountable, you have to recognize how you're contributing to the problem. A lot of us want to say that we have nothing to do with what happened. If we don't take full accountability for something, if you only say like partial of something, like my husband's favorite words, kind of, sort of, might have. Like, that's not you being accountable for the whole thing. So recognize that. See where you're a part of that, right? If I am literally robbing a bank, just being accountable, I robbed it. That's me. Even if I'm the getaway driver, if I help plan it, I'm accountable and I'm a part of that. During accountability, you have to discover what about it hurt you and what you need to get to heal. A lot of it is coming to a counselor or a therapist or a person like a relationship coach or life coach like myself and figuring out where the problem lies and how you're attached to it. If you detach yourself from something and somebody has to reattach you to it, it's probably somebody that you had to pay for, because most people don't reattach themselves to things that they don't want to have anything to do with. Apologize when you're being accountable. Do you know how big an apology and how far an apology will take you? Like, if a person needs to hear, I'm sorry, say it. What's the problem? Like, literally. I always say to myself, like, if that's what you need to hear to help you move on or help you gather your stuff and get it going, then that's what I'll need to do. And that's what I talk about in the humility chapter, is that accepting when you're wrong and making sure that you can apologize for it. Apologize when you're trying to be accountable. Because if you're accountable, then it belongs to you and you owe that to yourself. Also, in accountability, you have to acknowledge that you're toxic. This is what book two is all about. Realizing the toxic in you. Yes, we're all toxic. And you can sit up there and say, oh, I'm not toxic. That's not me. Sit. It's you. It is you. Toxic. Okay? And that's why we're in this accountability situation, that you have to recognize that you're toxic. And those toxins have accounted for other things that have been attached to you. So the moment that you recognize them and you take them into account and you say, hey, this is me, but I don't want it to belong to me, you can detach yourself from that. So remember, stay accountable.